Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to read a story, Jurmana by Munshi Premchand. Munshi Khairat Ali Khan was the inspector of sanitation and hundreds of sweeper women dependent on him. He was good-hearted and well thought of, not the sort who cut their prey, scolded them or fined them, but he went on regularly rebunking and punishing Alarkhi. She was not a shrieker, nor saucy, or slovenly. She was also not at all bad-looking. During these chilly days, she would be out with her broom before it was light and go on assiduously sweeping the road until 9. But all the same, she would be penalized. Hinsi, her husband, would help her with her work too when he found the chance. But it was in Alrakhi's fate that she was going to be fined. For others, payday was an occasion to celebrate. For Alrakhi, it was the time to weep. On that day, it was as though her heart had broken. Who could tell how much would be deducted? Like students awaiting the results of their examinations over and over again, she would speculate on the amount of deduction. Whenever she got so tired that she would sit down a moment to catch her breath, precisely then, the inspector would arrive riding in his ekka. No matter how much she would say, "Please, Excellency, I'll go back to work again," she would jot her name down in his book without listening. A few days later, the very same thing happened would happen again. If she bought a few cents worth of candy from the sweets vendor and started to eat it, just at that moment, the inspector would drop on her from the devil knew where and once more write her name down in his book. Where could he have been hiding? The minute she began to rest the least bit, he was upon her like an evil spirit. If he wrote her name down on only 2 days, how much would the penalty be then? God knew. More than 8 annas? If only it were not a whole rupee. With her head bowed, she would go to collect her pay and find even more deducted than she had estimated. Taking her money with trembling hands, she would go home, her eyes full of tears. There was no one to turn to, no one who would listen. Today was payday again. The past month, her unweaned daughter had suffered from coughing and fever. The weather had been exceptionally cold. Partially because of the cold, partially because of the little girl's crying, she was kept awake the whole night. Several times she would come to work late. Khan Sahib had noted down her name, and this time she would be fined half her pay. It was impossible to say how much might be deducted. Early in the morning, she picked up the baby, took her broom and went to the street. But the naughty creature wouldn't let herself be put down. Time after time, Alrakhi would threaten her with the arrival of the inspector. "He's on his way and he'll beat me as for you, he will cut off your nose and ears." The child was willing to sacrifice her nose and ears but not to be put down. At last, when Alrakhi had failed to get rid of her with threats and coaxing, alike she set her down and left her crying and wailing while she started to sweep. But the little wretch wouldn't sit in one place to cry her heart out. She crawled after her mother time and time again, caught her sari, clung to her legs that wallowed around on the ground, and a moment later sat up to start crying again. "Shut up," Alrakhi said, brandishing the broom. "If you don't, I will hit you with the broom and that will be the end of you. That bastard of an inspector's going to show up at any moment." She had hardly got the words out of her mouth when Inspector Khairat Ali Khan dismounted from his bicycle directly in front of her. She turned pale. Her heart began to thump. "Oh God, may my head fall off if he heard me. Right in front of me and I didn't see him. Who could tell he would come on his bicycle today? He's always come in his ikka." The blood froze in her veins. She stood holding the broom as though paralyzed. Angrily, the inspector said, "Why do you drag the kid after you to work? Why didn't you leave it at home?" "She's sick, Excellency," Alrakhi said timidly. "Who is at home to leave her with?" What's the matter with her? She has fever, Huzoor. And you make her cry by leaving her. Don't you care if she lives? How can I do my work if I carry her? Why don't you ask for leave? If my pay is cut, Huzoor, what will we have to live on? Pick her up and take her home. When Husseini comes back, send him here to finish the baby and was about to go when he asked, Why were you abusing me? Al-Rakhi felt all her breath knocked out of her. If you would cut her there, wouldn't have been any blood. Trembling, she said, No, Huzoor, may my head fall off if I was abusing you. And she burst into tears. In the evening, Husseini and Al-Rakhi went to collect her pay. She was very downcast. Why so sad? Husseini tried to console her. The pay is going to be cut, so let them cut it. I swear on your life, from now on, I won't touch another drop of booze or toddy. I'm afraid I'm fired. Damn my tongue. How could I? If you're fired, then you are fired. But let Allah be merciful to him. Why go on crying about it? You have made me come for nothing. Every one of those women will laugh at me. If he's fired you, won't we ask on what grounds? And who heard you abuse him? Can there be so much injustice that he can fire anyone he pleases? If I'm not heard, I'll complain to the panchayat. I'll beat my head on the headman's gate. If our people stuck together like that, would Khan Sahib ever dare fine us so much? No matter how serious the sickness, there is a medicine for it, silly. But Al-Rakhi was not set at rest. Dejection covered her face like a cloud. When the inspector heard her abuse him, why didn't he even scold her? Why didn't he re her on the spot? She was not able to work it out. He actually seemed kind. She could not manage to understand this mystery. She was afraid. He had decided to fire her. That must have been why he was so nice. She had heard that a man about to be hanged is given a fine last meal. They have to give him anything he wants, so surely the inspector was going to dismiss her. They reached the municipal office building. The pay began to be distributed. The sweeper women were first. Whoever's name was called would go running and taking her money. Call down, underserved blessings on the inspector and go away. Al-Rakhi's name was always called after the champas. Today she was passed over. After champa, Jahoran's name was called, and she always followed Al-Rakhi. Suddenly startled, she heard her name. Slowly she stood up and walked ahead with the slow tread of her new bride. The paymaster put the full amount of 6 rupees in her hand. She was stupefied. Surely the paymaster was mistaken. In these 3 years, she had never once got her full pay, and now to get even half would have been a windfall. She stood there for a second in case the paymaster should ask for the money back. When he asked her, Why are you standing here now? Why don't you move along? She said softly. But it's the full amount. Puzzled, the paymaster looked at her and said, What else do you want? Do you want to get less? There's no penalty deducted? No. Today there aren't any deductions. She came away, but in her heart she was not content. She was full of remorse for having abused the inspector.